here at Mountain HAVOC 2019. We're having a great morning. The weather's turned out beautiful out here.
Okay.
All right, Kelly, with Mountain Man coming up, what do you have to do to be ready for tomorrow?
Well, unfortunately, no one here has a spare chunk for an Axle Tech 4000. Managed to break the pinion off there on the rock course, but rear wheel drive tomorrow, I think we can still make her.
You actually finished the rest of that course in two wheel drive?
Hell yeah, man. Pedal to the metal.
Awesome, Kelly. Well, can't wait to see how you do on the Mountain Man.
Thank you. Looking forward to it.
Bud, you have been putting on a show. Every time I look around, I see your front two tires up in there. Tell us what's going on, Larry.
Well, not too good right now. Pretty sure we busted the front chunk in the process of trying to swap that out. Basically split the rear drive line in half, so we're trying to gather parts along with about probably 9 other people right at the moment, trying to get stuff back together so we can try to make it for tomorrow.
They're like catfish.
Yeah, you can. Nice job.
That was long. Think about your recovery. Oh, yeah, I'll just put your feet up, relax a little bit.
I've been thinking about keeping your problem.
I know. It's smart to not get out, dude, if you don't have to, because getting back in, I know it's a pain in the ass.
Pretty good. What did you think of that?
Well, that's a little heart attack when it's your spouse doing it.
Oh,
but I support him 100%.
Get a picture of that.
Hey, Bill.
Yeah, smile.
Hey, Bill.
What happens when you land upside down?
Bill.
Did you have you had your mouth closed, it looked like.
Oops. We got bigger tires, more belly clearance, so we'll see what happens.
And your favorite thing?
My favorite event is Mountain Man.
Oh.
I'm here with Jason Moon in your camp. You know, I see your family in the background. You had an awesome run on the rock course. You're probably in the top 10 right now. How are you feeling about your Havoc experience so far?
It'd be tough to wrap the whole experience into one other than we're still in shock. I mean, it's just been, since we got here, it's been a roller coaster ride, and we felt we've been doing pretty good so far, and we felt the rock course would be one of our better courses, and it panned out that way for us. We're very ecstatic about where we did placed on that one.
Mountain Man is tomorrow, bright and early. How are you feeling about attacking the Mountain Man?
I also believe the Mountain Man's going to be one of our stronger courses. I do. I think that with that coming up, the way the Blazer's set up, that's going to be a good course for us. We're looking for a strong finish and get us a little farther up the podium.
Thank you.
Jason Moon's one of those Warren sponsored drivers. Warren got him all dialed in right before this event. The cousins out here helping out. They're great. Great family guys out here.
feel?
Pretty good. Made a clean run. Rig stayed together. Couldn't ask for better.
That's a 2019 Havoc champion right there.
So what do you think? Could you have picked up the pace a little bit out there, you know?
No, it was pretty fast.
It was pretty fast. It was damn fast.
Yeah.
2 minutes.
2 minutes.
You're under 3 minutes. Yeah, that was fast.
Yeah, biggest thing, we just want to back up. You don't have to stop and back up. You got it.
I like how you did that turn, man. That was wicked.
Yeah,
nobody else did that.
Just to go for it was worth it.
Yeah, I was like, oh, don't flip.
It's just not typical.
We'll be right back.
Yeah. Bonners River and then High Desert, and we might go over to Idaho and do their I don't think we can, because I think High Desert and the Idaho mud event is all the same weekend now, because High Desert moved theirs up 1 weekend to not compete with the Ultra 4 race that's that weekend.
Okay.
So, but we've got time. We've got a few months to figure out what we want to do for a motor and get some seat time and dial it in. So.
Well, it was making some good power till.
Oh, it was making really good power at the end. I think the boost controller failed and it over 25 pounds right there at the end. That thing just, once we pulled the air cleaner off, that thing just stood up and launched up the hill. It scared the shit out of me. And then I looked down and saw my boost was over 25 and then it went. So it is what it is. We'll fix it and be back next time.
Sounds good. Can't wait.
Yep.
I see you got the Insanity Fab Winter Challenge.
Yeah.
Two-color.
This is the best fitting hat I've ever had in my life.
Nice. I need to get one of those.
Oh. He kind of said, like, you guys are awesome and you guys feed me and you guys are wicked and I will jump ship. So we just got a new FTR member right there.